आलयं करुणालयं नमामि भगवत्पादं शंकरं लोकशंकरं शंकरं शंकराचार्यं केशवं बादरायणं सूत्र भाष्यकृतौ वंदे भगवन्तौ पुनः पुनः ईश्वरो गुरुरात्मेति मूर्ति भेद विभागिने व्योमवद्व्याप्त देहाय दक्षिणामूर्तये नमः। सहनावतु सहनौ भुनक्तु सह वीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै। ॐ शान्तिश्शान्तिश्शान्तिः। यो ब्रह्माणुयाति पूर्वं वेदाश्च प्रणोति तस्मै तगुम्हदेवात्मवृत्तिप्रकाशं मुमुक्षुर्वै शरणमहं प्रपद्ये। ॐ शान्तिश्शान्तिश्शान्तिः। श्रीचिद्घनगणेश नमोऽयं सुखं नित्यं स्वप्रकाशं व्यापकं नामरूपे अधिष्ठानं बुद्ध्यबोध्यं बुद्धेर्दृक्यत्वनिर्वापारं सर्ववेदान्तवेद्यं प्रत्यक्परमः तदेव अहन्नमत्वन्यदिति मे निश्चिता मतिः। Not this word, we were earlier somewhere in the Tuppana. I think we finished the Moola before moving on to the 290th. So 290th. Laya Chintana Krama. We'll finish the Tippana. It's quite a long one. But it's, you know, it's an overview of the Jnani Chinna and what was said as, you know, Shrunvan Pashyan Shrunvan Ityadi. So we look at this quickly. Jnani Naha Sarvata. I think, yeah, here. We are here. That is right. So Rago Lingam Abodase iti Shastra Prasiddhi. I thought that this was Moola, so I said actually on this page there is no Moola at all. It is all Tippana. So you are here. Jnanina Sarvata Raganudaye Tasya Sharira Sthiti Nimitta Bhojanado Api Apravruttapatyam Jnanina Prarabdhanuvo Nasti iti Apadyeta. What was said earlier is Jnanina Manasaha Antarmukataya Ati Ativa Upashantatvat. There is a lot of say over the Antakkarana and the Indriyas. Therefore, being Antarmukha, Jnani's mind is turned inward, and being turned inward, Ativa Upashanta, it is quite at peace. There is no craving, there is no hankering towards the Vishayas within and without. Not only outside, in the Antakkarana also, there is no craving. And what I said, this raga isn't there. This is the idea there. Rago lingam abodasya. And abodha can also be taken as a jnani also. Jnani, abodha means ajnani. So bodha will be jnani. Bodha asya asti iti bodha. That is also another possible meaning. We can say it is a raga is Ajnani Lakshana, or we can say Ajnala Lakshana. Both are possible. Lands in the same meaning. Itihi Shastra Prasiddhi. Thereby you know that Jnani does not have Raga. If that is true, then there is a Purva Paksha. Jnanina Sarvatha Raga Anudaye. Ragasya Anudaye. If Raga does not come up, then why will Jnani have any Pravritti? Prarabdha is also not possible. That is the idea here. Jnanina sarvata raganudaye tasya sharirasthiti nimitta. At least you say sharirasthiti matra. Raga should be there. Bhojanadav. So sharirasthiti nimitta bhojanadav api apravruttapatyam. There will be apravrutti in sharirasthiti nimitta bhojana also. In that case, jnanina prarabdha anubhavanasti iti apadyeta. Sanchita and Agami karmas are destroyed when the jnana takes place. But Prarabdha continues. Without Prarabdha, Sharira wouldn't be there. If Sharira isn't there, there won't be Guru Shishya Sampradaya taught by the jnani to an ajnani. You cannot have ajnani gurus all the while. That is the case. That would be the conclusion resultant. If jnani's prarabdha isn't there, then the sharira will drop off. If sharira drops off, then the corollary of that is those who are there in sharira, they are ajnanis, because as soon as jnana takes place, sharira drops off, prarabdha gets over. In which case, those who are continuing the sampradaya through and through, Sadashiva Samarambham, we say that parampara is being taught by ajnani to ajnanis. That won't help. So prarabdha is there. And now if you say raga isn't there, then sharira sthiti nimitta bhojanado api apravrtapatyam jnanina prarabdha anubhava nasti iti apadyata. Jnani does not have prarabdha anubhava, but I am giving an extension. If one accepts that, okay, jnani does not have prarabdha anubhava, so what? So what? There are a lot of repercussions. Even the sampradaya will become invalidated. Nacha iyam apatti ishta eva iti vaktum shakyate. And you cannot say this is ishtapatti. Okay. I mean, jnani does not have prarabdha anubhava. We would like that kind of a situation as well. We would accept that kind of a conclusion as well. You can't say that. Karmanusarena praninam phaladatuhu ishwarasya ichchaya jnanina api prarabdha anubhavasya avashyakatvat. Because of karma which has been done, which has already started fructifying, as per Ishwara's ichcha, it has started working. And what is that ichcha? The karma vyavastha. The niyati of karma vyavastha which is there, that should be perfect. It cannot be, you know, once in a while it works, sometimes it doesn't work. That is why it is a niyati. It is meticulously made in such a manner that even if someone hides and does some punya or papa karma, it will still come to light to Ishwara, who is Sarvadhi Sakshi, and it will result. Even in the case of jnani, if it has started fructifying, it will fructify as long as sharira is there. That prarabdha bhoga has to be undergone bhoga of. So karma anusarana praninam phaladhatu ishwarasya. That phaladhata ishwara has made this possible for a jnani also. Prarabdha anubhava. Jnani na api prarabdha anubhavasya avashyakatvat. Then how do you put this together now? On one hand, you are saying that jnani does not have raga unto any vishaya, including, so that will include bhojanado api. Then how will the sharira keep ticking? And on the other hand, you say that prarabdha is definitely there for jnani also. Tasma jnanino api prarabdha phalanubhavani anyatha. So prarabdha phalanubhavanyatha upapatya bhojanado iccha udeti iti vachyam iti chet. So this is the Purva Paksha so far. So what is the Purva Paksha asking? Now there is a contradiction. You cannot say that prarabdha isn't there, and you cannot say that raga isn't there. So how will you solve this contradiction? Tasma jnanino api prarabdha phala anubhava anyatha anubhapatya. Otherwise it is not possible. Without raga there cannot be bhojanadav pravritti. If it is there, then only prarabdha is possible. Otherwise, not possible. So, prarabdha phala anubhava has to be there. Without that, it is not possible. So, anyatha anubhapatti is the basis for arthapatti pramana. Therefore, bhojanadav iccha udeti iti vachyam iti chet. So, you have to accept that at least in bhojana ityadi, there has to be raga for the jnani. Tanna. So that is countered, saying that yes, prarabdha is there. But to say that jnani has raga towards bhojana ityadi, that is not right. Prarabdha janito raga adihi yatha jnaninaha iccha virahe api bhavati tathayava tasya mithya jnana bhavat prarabdha phala bhoge अदृढ़ आभास रूप रागावास रूपो रागो जायते. इट डज दिस डज नॉट लुक लाइक मिथ्या अज्ञान. आई डोंट आई नीड टू लुक इट अप. जस्ट गिव मी अ मोमेंट. आई नीड टू सी द एरर. दिस डजंट लुक राइट. 179 अनलेस समवन एल्स आल्सो हैज इट. 179. I don't want to scroll back, so I have a printed book. I'll just check there. 179. Vivechana. Swantha. No, nothing marked there. Anyway, it looks like a typo, which has been missed in errata also. Let's try to make sense of this. So, tanna prarabdha janita rogadi. So, sorry, prarabdha janita rogadi yata. I read it as ragadi. This mithya jnana bhavat does not seem to be right here. So we'll see what it means. Tanna prarabdha janita rogadihi yatha jnanina iccha virahi api bhavati. And this is not only in the case of jnani. In the case of ajnani also. How does roga come in? Roga is a disease. So how does disease come in? Nobody wants the disease, right? There is no raga towards the roga. So prarabdha janita roga. Roga ityadi come by because they are due in prarabdha. One has done a particular karma. As a phala to that, there is roga also. Papa phala. So rogadi vishaye yatha iccha nasti. Kasyachidapi. Jnaninava ajnaninava rogadi vishaye yatha iccha virahe api. It may appear that one wants it. One wants to lie in bed. At least that much you will have to accept. You will conclude, the entire day this fellow is lying in bed. But he has roga. You may not know that he has roga, but it is not that he wants to be in bed. That wanting to be in bed, just relaxing, may be the corollary there. One may infer from seeing someone lazing on the bed, not knowing that the person is unwell. And somebody who is inherently lazy, even in roga or not having roga, that person may want to be on the bed. So the person who is looking at that kind of a lazy person may conclude that this fellow is just wanting to lie on the bed. He is lazy, which is an erroneous conclusion when that person has roga. Especially in the case of an active person who does not want to be bedridden, but still that fellow will also be confined to the bed. And this shows us that the onlooker's perspective is not right. In the case of the jnani also, here rogadi yatha jnaninah prarabdha janitah bhavati iccha virahe api. Even if there is no iccha towards the roga ityadi, obviously prarabdha vashat it will come by. तथा एव तस्य मिथ्या ज्ञानाभावात् प्रारब्ध फल भोगे. I don't really see how this fits in here. मिथ्या ज्ञानाभावात् प्रारब्ध फल भोगे. सो प्रारब्ध फल भोगे इच्छा विरहे अपि ज्ञानिनः प्रारब्धि प्रारब्ध जनित प्रारब्ध फल भोगे अदृढ़ आभास रूप रागाभास रूप रागः जायते. सो आई ड्रॉप दिस. आई एम रियली नॉट एबल टू फिट दिस एट ऑल हियर. सो मिथ्या ज्ञान अभाव कांट बी देयर. सो मिथ्या ज्ञान भावात इज पॉसिबल. सो मिथ्या ज्ञान भावात नॉट अभावात. सो इफ दैट इज द केस इट फिट्स इन समहाउ. बट अदरवाइज मिथ्या ज्ञानस्य अभाव तस्य ज्ञानिनः डज सी ज्ञानी हैविंग मिथ्या ज्ञान अभाव इटसेल्फ हैज नो मीनिंग. So this can be mithya jnana bhavat. So tasya mithya jnana bhav mithya. So mithya is an avyaya. So I don't think it will become hraswa also. Mithya jnana bhavat. It will not be mithya jnana. It will be mithya jnana. Mithya jnana bhavat. So this akara has somehow shifted here. It should have been here. This is my thinking here. So due to his understanding of everything being mithya. So just like he knows roga ityadi is mithya, but and does not have ichha in roga as well as swasthya. He does not crave to be healthy, and he does not have dvesha towards roga. So he has no raga towards roga, has no dvesha towards roga. So he does not have raga or dvesha towards roga or swasthya. We can take both in the case of roga as well as aroga. So prarabdha phala bhoge api, he has no ichha towards prarabdha phala bhoga, but he still has to undergo prarabdha phala. Prarabdha phala bhoga adrudha abhasuru. But then that raga, how is that raga? He does not have raga towards anything, but that abhasarupa raga is there. So what I said, raga is an abhasa. He knows this raga which comes up. It is not that the raga isn't there. You cannot say the raga is there. So what is a counter where an agreement can be made? Purva Pakshi is saying without raga there cannot be bhojanadu pravritti. Siddhanti wants to say jnani does not have raga. But in vyavahara there is pravritti towards bhojana. So anyatha anupapatti is there. Why is he eating if he does not have any raga? So prarabdha is the answer, but it isn't convincing enough. For many, it is not convincing enough. So what do we say? Do you understand the concept of mithya? Sarasadbhyam vilakshana. So sadvilakshana, asadvilakshana. So we are saying there is raga, but it is not sadraga. Do we say it is asad then, completely non-existent? We would like to say that, but it is not acceptable to the Purva Pakshi. So you have to say mithya raga. Mithya has already been taught. Raga in the case of an ajnani is not mithya. In the case of a sadhaka also, not mithya all the time. Only when in Vedanta Shravana, that time this raga appears to be mithya. But under the pressure of that vasana, raga and dvesha can be so dhrida, vasana can be so strong that one cannot give up. So in that case, it is not mithya. But in the case of a jnani, although it is tuchha, we have to explain it to the other as it is mithya. So he says, mithya jnanasya bhavat. Because of that understanding of mithya, raga being mithya, prarabdha phala bhoge adrudha abhasa rupa raga bhasa rupa raga jayate. So what kind of raga? Raga is abhasa rupa. Therefore that raga will be called as raga bhasa rupa. Raga is raga bhasa rupa, and that is adrudha abhasa rupa. It is not going to be creating, you know, pressure in the jnani to act it out. This is why bhiksha, you know, bhiksha also has rules. You go to 5 houses. If you can get bhiksha, well and good. If you don't get bhiksha, you do upavasa. Upasamipe vasa. So stay with the atma jnana, and that itself will consume your hunger. So try to withdraw, because in prarabdha you don't have food that day. Why do you fight it out? Just, you know, that is why even before jnana, the body has to be trained, the mind has to be trained with upavasa ityadi, not very in harsh manners, not tamasika tapaha. Tapaha should be as guided by the shastra. It should be moderate, but it should be sufficient enough so that after jnanodaya, the hunger does not take you away from the nishtha all the time. Sometimes you should be able to accept that there is no food, which is okay. So jnani has already, as in sadhaka avastha itself, he would have trained his mind. And in jnana, it will consume the hunger also. So even if there is hunger, he knows that it is, there is raga. There will be desire to eat, but that desire is mithya, just like hunger is mithya. And although, you know, the hunger can overpower at times, many a time, jnani will not have this, you know, idea of I need to have food, or at least we have to say that hunger may be overpowering, but this kind of food, that necessarily shouldn't be there, it wouldn't be there. Adrudhatvadeva saragha svanivruttaye na vedanta vicharadikam apekshate. And vedanta vichara, to counter that mithyatva, is not needed, because mithya nischaya has taken place pre-jnana itself. He does not need to think that it is mithya. This abhasarupa raga is adrudha. It is not so firm that it will pull the jnani down to the level of an ajnani. So there is a difference. So nivruttaye na vedanta vicharadi vicharadikam apekshate. Does not have an expectancy of him to do vichara. Vichara is for whom? Vichara sagara is for a sadhaka. After that vichara, vichara, you cross over the sagara, bhava sagara. After that, vichara is not needed. Vichara is needed to get into nishtha. Once nishtha is there, then vichara is needed only when there is a slippage. And that doesn't take place for an advanced jnani. As and when the vasanas go away, the vasanas become adrida, ragadi become adrida, and nishtha becomes drida. So I am adrida raga, swayat tattvena, bharjita bijavat durbalatvena cha, sharira siti matra nimitta shastriya bhoga matra hetur bhavati. Anyway, just taking a detour here. In Panchadashi, Bhagavan Vidyaranyacharya talks about prarabdha as being of three types. In the Saptamodhyaya, Vidyaranyacharya talks about prarabdha itself of three types. He says ichha prarabdha, anichha prarabdha, and paravasha prarabdha. There are three types of prarabdhas. In every case, but in the case of jnani, this is interesting to be inquired into. What kind of prarabdha? So this is what ichha prarabdha is. Here this raga is ichha prarabdha. What kind of ichha? This is, abhasa. Ichha abhasa rupa ichha. That is the raga here. That prarabdha, which is due at a particular moment in time, for the jnani sharira, sharira dvaya, the sukshma or stula, it will generate abhasa rupa raga in the antakarana, ichha. Without even inquiring much, the jnani knows. Initially, through inquiry, later, without inquiry also, the jnani knows that this raga is due to prarabdha, let it be. And since the training is there of dharma across decades, adharma raga won't come up. So dharmika raga also he need not give in to. And even if he does give in to, because prarabdha is due, he is not attached. It will not create additional vasanas. Because that karma will be agami karma. Agami karma nashyate. Jnane neva nashyate. So agami karma, meaning even if he acts out the abhasarupa ichha which has come up, it will not bind the jnani, because agami karma won't leave vasanas, they burn out. Phala won't be there. So what will be there? There will be no new phala to the new karma, but the old phala will be exhausted. In the case of anicca also, anicca prarabdha was also like that. So jnani does not desire anything. So if it is good, it is by prarabdha. If it is bad also, it is prarabdha. He has to accept that some papa phala is fructifying, in which case he did not desire. So in the case of roga ityadi, roga is not desired, anicca prarabdha. Even without desiring, it is there. And it can be good or bad also. And we need not take only a bad example in anicca. Just like in iccha and anicca, both good and bad are possible. Sometimes neither there is an iccha, nor there is, anicca also. He can't categorize into anicca. Why didn't desire it, but it still came by. Sometimes, it is clearly seen that it is para iccha driven. In the case of avataras, we have seen how avataras take place. Avataras cannot be having their own karma. So their karma is the samashti karma. So that samashti karma is para iccha prarabdha. In the case of avataras, it is very clear, but in the case of jnanis also, you can see, and ajnanis also, You don't desire it. You didn't want it. You didn't not want it also. And you can still see why is it happening. There is especially, you know, marriages, prabala prarabdha. Marriage is a prabala prarabdha. If it is, it has to happen, the person will be dragged to that spouse alone. You know, in other faiths, they have this, you know, marriages are made in heaven. Married people know how much of heaven it is. Yes, it may be, I'm not denying, but then it is not always heaven, right? It is not always heavenly. Heavenly is a very little period of time. If you look at sukha, not only in marriage, outside marriage also, sukha is little. In comparison to dukkha, sukha is little, at least for a sadhaka. Pariksha lokan, one knows, having encountered all sorts of experiences, one is able to conclude that there is no nitya sukha. There is no long duration of sukha also. Long duration is dukkha. So, parecha prarabdha. Other wants to, you know, and we see these, you know, in cases, you know, one does not want to marry, the other wants to marry, and then they get married. So, prabala prarabdha. Even in case of friendships, somehow we don't want to be friends with someone, but prarabdha is such, especially a sadhaka. Sadhaka wants to avoid the company. Earlier, he was a friend, let's say. Now, he wants to avoid the company of whatever, you know, social drinkers or whatever. And they drag this person. What kind of a friend are you? They drag him. Does not want to go. Slowly starts distancing, but prarabdha is so strong that, you know, something or else will pull that person to get into the same crowd again and again and again. Very clear in the case of an ajnani, but for a jnani also, parecha prarabdha. In any case, what is this raga like, vasana? Any type of this prarabdha creates some raga. What is it? So, soyam adrida raga. The raga which is not firm, raga. Swayatatvena bharjita bijavat durbalatvena cha sharira sthiti matra nimitta shastriya bhoga matre hetur bhavati. So generally dharmika ragas will be there. And how will these ragas be there? We have seen abhasa rupa. So what is this abhasa rupa? Bharjita bijavat. Like a burnt seed, they will not fructify. Fructify in the sense, now bijas have two nimittas. So we can, you know, seeds, you bring in seeds and, you know, nowadays you get the watermelon seeds or sunflower seeds or whatever. These are the very seeds which will be plowed, and then you can sow the seed and you can get watermelon or, you know, sunflowers out of them. But the same sunflower seeds, if they are roasted, bharjita bija, if you roast them, watermelon seeds or whatever, you know, any fruit, any vegetable, if you roast them and then you sow them, put any amount of water and fertilizer, it won't germinate. But you can consume them. If you like eating sunflower seeds or watermelon seeds, you will really enjoy them. So bhoga is there, but still they cannot give phala in another sense. They'll give bhoga rupa phala, but they won't give you the additionally, they won't germinate. They will not create more vasanas. So very nice example of bharjita bija. This is there in Panchadashi Saptamodhyaya also. Bharjita bija vat durbalatvena cha. Because the being durbala, like a bharjita bija, like a roasted seed incapable of germinating, sharira sthiti matra nimitta shastriya bhoga matre hetur bhavati. They will lead the jnani to shastriya dharmika bhoga, which is due for fructification, but won't leave any impressions further. Natu vyasana karani bhuta shastra nishiddha bhoga hetuhu. Whereas adharma, in the case of an ajnani, leaves an impression. Dharma also does, but adharma binds the person, drags to the level of, you know, adhogati. They bring adhogati. Here it will not be vyasana, it will not be addictive for the jnani. In the case of an ajnani, every action will leave an impression and cause the person to be drawn towards that karma if it is enjoyable. So it will create raga, raga rupa vasana, or raga bija rupa vasana, and then if it is unpleasant, then it will create an impression which is dvesha roopa or dvesha roopa vasana, or that which will lead to dvesha. Vasana which will create dvesha, vasana which will create raga. These are the impressions created for an ajnana. That is vyasana, addictive. Vyasana karani bhuta shastra nishiddha bhoga hetuhu na bhavati jnaninaha. Apicha jnaninaha vishaya satyata bhrantya bhavat. Jnani does not have vishaya satta bhranti. Ajnani thinks that the vishaya is real. So he has mithya jnana. He has mithyatva nishchaya regarding vishayas. So jnanya vishaya satyata bhranti bhrante hai abhavat. Pratyut dridatara vishaya mithyatva nishchaya janita tivratara vairagya balacha dridarago naiva bhavati. Ayam artha spashtam shashta tarange vakshate. So this idea will be elaborated further in the sixth chapter. This is a tippana. Tippanakara is saying that I am jumping ahead to explain if somebody is stuck with this. So he is explaining in too much of detail, but it is useful, you know, because vairagya for a jnani, how can this be? All these questions create obstacles for a sadhaka. How will it be? Even after jnana, one will have these questions. So these are resolved here. So therefore, dridatara vishaya mithyatva nischaya. Mithyatva nischaya is dridha, whereas the raga is adridha. Therefore, tivra vairagya is there. With that strength of tivra vairagya, the raga cannot become dridha. Athava, now another side is being looked at. Athava shakagram va rajyum va aruya nrityato api mallasya chittam yatha swavalambe eva jagarukam bhavati yatha va kshirapurnam kumbham dhritva gachantyaha yoshitaha pathi swasakhi vihi sa varta sallapadikam kurvanayaha api chittam kshire eva ekagram bhavati tatha. So two examples are given. Yatha, just like, you know, you look at a person who is skilled in acrobatics, or, you know, some kind of a circus. You look at acrobatics. So one, somebody is, you know, just the, it's a thin branch compared to the sharira of the acrobat. You see how on a thin, shakagra here is an example. But in modern this thing, in gymnastics, you see Olympics and all that. People walking on rope and people walking on in a circus and all that, you see on a very thin and lightweight piece of wood, stick. So like a shakagra, like a branch of a tree, or rajju, you know, or a tight rope. You see, they are walking. So when they are walking, they also are creating an entertainment value. So where is their mind? Is it on the rope, tight rope that they are walking, or is it to, you know, show off and come out as, you know, an excellent performer? So performance is also involved there. So nrityata, here specifically dancing there on the, so an additional complexity is added there. Not only walking, dancing on it, or a tight rope, or a shakagra on a branch. If one is doing, showcasing that skill, so performance skill is also there, and one has to be alert to the jnana also, that he is walking on the rope. So in the case of jnani, that is a comparison. He has to perform in the world, if he is performing in the world, or in the case of a sannyasi also, bhiksha, he has to perform, he has to go and ask for bhiksha, bhavati bhikshan dehi. So at least that much you have to accept. But still, the mind is in the tattva. So that is explained here with an example. So that malla, that acrobat who is dancing on the tight rope or on the branch of a tree, mallasya chittam, tasya chittam, yatha swavalambe eva jagarukam bhavati. It is alert to the balance on the rope. So the mind is alert on the balance. The performance is taking place, but still, what is his main focus? Main focus is not to show off. Main focus, his mind is still consumed on, I should not fall off the rope. यथा वा क्षीरपूर्णं कुंभं धृत्वा. सो यू सी विलेज साइट्स एटलीस्ट इन द अर्लियर दिस थिंग और इवन नाउ इन विलेज साइट्स सम ओल्ड सेटअप्स यू नो यू सी पीपल कैरिंग especially you know ladies carrying this pot what you read in purana kathas also leela krishna leela in that kind of a section so you see you know ladies carrying pot here the thing is you know filled with milk so they carry milk in the pot on their head so it need not be milk it can be anything but then the example given is kshira purnam kumbham dhritva gacchantya yoshitah for a lady who is carrying the milk on the in the pot on the head but still she is chatting with her friends they are all going together pathi swasaki bhi sa varta sallapadikam kurvanaya api she can even let go of the pot on the head you know still they are able to balance all this right why this you can look at even in cities you see many laborers carry a lot of you know even coolies You look at them; they carry so much of weight on their head. They don't even hold it. Even if you hold it, we can't. You know, with four people also, if we hold it, it'll fall off. We can't walk. So their mind is trained. Their kala is such that their mind is focused on that. They'll be chatting with you. You know, you'll be bargaining as well while going. But still. And he knows where to go, which direction, carrying that weight. Or she knows, you know, without dropping the kumbha, here in the example, kshira purnam. While chatting also, the focus is there. Similarly, for in the case of jnani, tatha jnani nopi chittam prarabdha vashad apatata visheshu pravuttam api visheshata lakshe swatma surupa eva nishtitam bhavati. So in bold, what is written here, that is important. Visheshu pravuttam api jnani naha chittam prarabdha vashad apatata. So it is Vishayas are not the focus. They are due to prarabdha. Under the influence of prarabdha, jnani sharira dvaya has to undergo that bhoga. Because it is like a short arrow, cannot be pulled back. Isharas niyati. Then, visheshu pravruttam api chittam visheshataha lakshe swatma swarupe eva nishtitam bhavati. Where is the jnani's nishtha? It is there only in swatma swarupa even while one is engaged in laukika vyavahara unto vishayas due to influence of prarabdha kincha jnano dehendriyadi vargaha vina eva ragam prarabdha phalatvena upagata darshanadi kriya eva krutarthatam yati so krutarthata is there vina ragam ragam vina eva so that much is sufficient here atascha swatma swarupe avasthitasya jnana prarabdha phalayata bhoga bhaseshu bhoga abhasa is there teshu na dridatara raga sambhava there is no raga unto prarabdha krita bhogas for the jnani why swatma swarupe avasthitasya jnaninah this is the hetu garbha visheshana for the jnani that jnani whose antakarana is consumed in the atma swarupa swatma swarupe avasthitasya jnaninah then why does he have this bhoga vishaya pravrutti prarabdha phalavashat prarabdha phalayata bhoga bhaseshu there is an abhasa that takes the sharira unto those vishayas but still na dridatara raga sambhava jnaninah kadachit vishaya pravrutti hetu bhuta prarabdhavatah jnaninah manah matta gajendravat pramattam sat visheshu vikshiptam api even if you say someone sees that no he I can see that the person had jnani has so much of intense desire so much of anger or whatever matta gajendravat like an intoxicated uncontrollable elephant is uncontrollable there is nothing to control an elephant if the elephant goes wild it is wild that's it No one can do anything. Even the mahuta, 100 mahutas also cannot do anything. So matta gajendravat, if it appears so in the case of the jnani, manaha, definitely the mind is turbulent. If one concludes that mana matta gajendravat pramattam sat visheshu vikshiptam api, even if it is drawn towards the vishayas, visheshu dosha drushtya atmaka, dosha drushtya दृष्ट्यात्मक, सो इट्स नॉट अ दृष्ट्या, इट इज दृष्ट्यात्मक, दोष दृष्ट्यात्मक विवेक मृगेन्द्रोन्मेषात् झटित्येव विक्षेपात् विमुक्तं प्रशांतं भवति. इवन इफ इट इज देयर नॉट अपेरेंट, ज्ञानी नोज दैट माय प्रारब्ध इज सो स्ट्रांग दैट इज जनरेटिंग सो मच ऑफ रागा एंड इट इज ड्रॉन टुवर्ड्स विषयास, looks uncontrollable, but still he has a background of this, he has training in that, he has trained himself across years, therefore he can do dosha drishti darshana. No, this will drag me back to samsara, it is addictive, there is no sukha there, really there is no sukha, it is atma sukha which is reflecting there, vishayas are mithya, drishyatvat mithya, all these are there. Therefore, dosha drishtyatmaka viveka. Viveka which is in the form of looking at the doshas in the vishayas. Mrugendronmeshat. So, jhatityeva vikshepat vimuktam prashantam bhavati. You see the deer also. You look at a deer. Keeps on jumping here and there. Very chanchala. So, you can look at it, you know, both ways. A deer, you know, musk deer, this is that the musk is from the deer, does not know that it is, it's its own smell, it keeps on hunting that here and there. So that is one example, that is the, that can be the meaning of this example. Another meaning is that the deer likes to hear a sound also. That's how, you know, the those who capture the deer, I don't want to say hunters, you know, very unfortunate, but then that's what it is. So they play some sound, it seems, whereby the deer gets attracted and it'll get stuck there. Try to listen to that and it just stands there and gets caught. Vishayas are like that. For a jnani also, he can do dosha darshana there. And then once one knows, just like the deer knows that, if it knows that I am getting trapped, then it can start jumping and running away from the vishayas. So swantakarane तीव्र रागाभावात् भोगहेतु प्रारब्ध सत्वाच्च ज्ञानी गंगा निर्मग्नार्ध गात्र पुरुषैव ज्ञानी मुख्यतया स्वस्वरूपे स्वरूप सुखे रमते. सो आत्मा राम, वी हैव सीन दिस, दी तीव्र रागा रागानाम अभावात् और रागस्य अभावात्, दी रागा इज देयर बट इट इज नॉट दृढ़, इट इज अदृढ़ रागा, इट इज नॉट तीव्र रागा. सो इट इज भोगहेतु, प्रारब्धवशात् भोगहेतु भवति. And this jnani, ganga nirmagnardha gatra purushaiva jnani mukhyataya swaswarupe ramate. So like a person, example given is that a person standing in ganga, but you know, half of his body is above the ganga. So even then, swaswarupe ramate, that is the idea, mukhyataya, amukhyataya, mukhyataya he is consumed in the atma tattva, amukhyataya there is indulgence in vishayas, because it is adrida. Amukhyataya vetana grahi bhrutaka iva klesham sahamana tivra prarabdha phalam cha anubhavati. So another example is given, just like a somebody who is, you know, assisting, serving. So like a servant who is vetana grahi. Why is a person serving? May not be really interested in serving, but serving because needs vetana, needs the wages, and therefore even if a, you know, klesham sahamanah iva, as though, you know, this, even if the master insult the servant, he says it's okay, I mean he hears it and says it's okay. Why? Because his focus is on wages. I am doing this for my salary, it's okay. I mean, and need not be a servant. And most of us who have actually had jobs, not businesses where we are not our own owners, we look at, you know, even in the case of business, the customer is the boss. So the customer comes around and insults, we accept it, it's okay, because my interest is in his money. Similarly, the boss may not be paying the salary, but if I don't take the insults of the boss, then there won't be salary at all. Similarly, this jnani also, the sharira undergoing bhoga is an insult to the jnani, right? From a from one perspective. He said it's okay because his interest is in just to live out the prarabdha. He does not care for the sharira at all. His interest is in the nishtha, and sharira is what? Is a sadhana. It's an adhikarana. So, therefore, this klesham sahamana iva tivra prarabdha phalam cha anubhavati. Shithila prarabdha phalabhuta nishiddha vishayan prayatnena pariharati cha. And if there is an effort needed for some, you know, loosened or some weak prarabdha phalal which are in the adharma rupa, because he has already won over the weak, he has made them weak. He has made them shithili. Shithili, he has made them shithili by sadhana earlier. So, adharma vasanas, adharmika vasanas have become weakened, but they may still be there. If they are there, then nishiddha vishayan prayatnena pariharati cha. He may need a little effort, and he takes that effort to deny that adharma to himself. Tathapi, jnani nirbhinna hridaya granthehe jnanina antakkaranasya kshina vasanatvat tivratara raga bhavaccha. Kshina vasanatvat tivratara raga bhavaccha. I think this should be akara here. Raga bhavaccha. Nishiddha vishaya parityagena adrida ragena vihita vishaya bhogeyapi vikala purusha chittasya iva jnanina antakkaranasya na mukhya taya mukhyata na mukhyata ityayam abhiprayaha ityayam abhipraya. So what is the idea? The sum up is that these kshina vasanas are there is raga abhava, dridatara raga abhava, tivratara raga abhava, and the antakarana is in the jnani state. So we have seen this multiple times, so I'll you know just skim through these. Indriyani indriyarteshu vartanta iti jadendriyanam eva swasva visheshu pravruttim varnayata gita shlokena bodhyate. And this we have seen in multiple quotations of the 5th chapter, 7, 8, 9 verses, and then elsewhere also guna guneshu vartante. So indriyani indriyarteshu guna guneshu, they are understood by the jnani, those shlokas, and the meaning is completely understood. So he has mithyatva nishchaya. Jnani yuvatim anubhavanapi. Now we have landed on the grahastha. So there, sannyasi, what was said in the mula, jnani yuvatim anubhavanapi sannyasi. Iti uktehe ayam ashaya. What is the idea? So here, man is taken as an example, and the flip side is true for a woman also. But here, if you take the jnani as a purusha, yuvatim anubhavanapi. So if he is, you know, interacting with the with a spouse also, interacting, having relations. So there, yuvatim anubhavanapi sannyasi. How do you say is a sannyasi? So this sannyasi is not mukhyartha here. Sannyasi iva sannyasi, because jnani sannyasi iva. That's the idea here. Not necessarily a sannyasi, grahastha, but like a sannyasi. But still, grahastha dharma is there. He has to beget children. So let's say jnani got married, or even before jnana had, he got married and it got jnana, or you in early years, or he had jnana but got married due to prabala prarabdha, because marriage is prabala prarabdha. Something happened and then he had to marry, or he did not consider that, you know, I need to marry, need not marry. It's okay. Get married. Live a dharmika life. And for loka sangraha, let me do all the karmas, vaidika karmas. Let me, you know, beget children, bring them in a dharmika ways, and let them serve the society also. Very good thinking. This is the dharmika way. Whether it is for a jnani or an ajnani. Now, jnani, considering this jnani, is married, he cannot live a sannyasi life. So he has to beget children. To beget children, he has to have relations with his spouse. So in that case, still he will be like a sannyasi. Because it is not for bhoga. It is for the dharmika purpose, he is wanting to beget children, which is a grahastha dharma also. Marriage is not for the sake of, you know, living a childless life. It is not planned. Nobody plans it. If it is planned, so see, one does not get children is okay. That is understandable. even with medical effort, because prarabdha is so strong that there are cases where even with efforts, in fact, in these days, so much of adulteration in food and God knows what all, you know, soap, what it is made of, we don't know the side effects at all. Mobile, laptops, so many things, cigarettes, alcohol, all the lifestyle, tensions, all this, you know, makes both man and woman weak. And in fact, I have seen many cases in the family, outside the family, where for years, you know, they're trying, but they cannot beget children. After many years, with help, with, you know, guidance, they are able to beget children. So this is the unfortunate bane of the society today. But there are some couples who plan to get married for whatever reasons, but they do not want children at all. That is adharma, because marriage is for the lineage to continue. So in that case, we are not looking at those cases. So we are looking at what the marriage for the very purpose of outgrowing the desires and serving the society by bringing up dharmika children, begetting them and bringing them up. So in that context, also, when the jnani is not indulging for the sake of bhoga, but indulging for the sake of society, for dharmika procreation, then it is what? It is, the jnani is said to be like a sannyasi. So with that context, now we'll just read through. There's not much here in that sense. Viraktasya dareshanataha vittitasya sannyasina jnanina na strivoga prasaktihi. Sannyasi, real sannyasi, has no stri bhoga at all. Tasya sri prasakto vyutthana shastram nirarthakam bhavet. What will happen? Because it has, sannyasa is nyasa, samyak nyasa for anything and everything, from people and things. Therefore, you cannot say that I will, you know, continue to be with my wife and call yourself a sannyasi. Vantashi sa sannyasi, sannyasyevana bhavati. So anyway, this word is, you know, I'll just mention it anyway. People who understand this, well and good. If they don't understand, also well and good. So vantashi, you know, what is given up, one does not consume that again. That's the idea. I don't want to go into details. So one has given up the spouse, man or woman. Then you again do not go back there. And it is in the case of vishayas also. So sannyasi eva na bhavati. There may be a typo here. It should be sannyasi eva. So yeah, sannyasi eva na bhavati. Kintu veshadhari dambiko grastad api adhamo apujyascha. So sannyasi is pujya because it is shreshta ashrama. Vairagya is there. All that is lacking in a person who calls himself a sannyasi, but he has all sorts of bhogas. That is not right. He is worse than he is a veshadhari. He is just a bahurupi. He is not a sannyasi in the true sense. He is just wearing the sannyasi clothes. He is worse than a grahastha, really. Grahastha has adhikara to have certain bhogas which are not to be had by the brahmachari or the sannyasi. So that person is not sannyasi at all. Therefore, what is the conclusion here? And this is the reason that jnani yuvatim anubhavanapi sannyasi, that is parisheshat grahaste jnanini stri bhoga prasajyate. So this statement is made in the case of not of a sannyasi, but sannyasi eva grahastaha. So grahaste jnanini stri bhoga prasajyata. That is how the Tippanakara is saying that from Mula, you have to understand why is it not a sannyasi, it is a grahastha. So jnani grahastha dhrita dhritashinaha tailapane pravruttivat santanarthi san shastra vidhim anatikramyam vidhina odham jaya mrutakale gachannapi na lipyate. So we have seen this. Yatahasa bhoga satya na striyam gachati vishayam ichhyatva darshanena viveka vairagyadi sampannatva. So viveka vairagya ityadi is there. So he is indulging only for putra or putri. Tadrsha grahastha jnani upachara sannyasi iti uchyate. So upachara, secondary meaning is sannyasi for a grahastha jnani. Sannyasina eva tasya api viveka vairagyadi sampannatva, and not necessarily a grahastha. Brahmachari also, or any other ashrama except sannyasa ashrama. If a person is a jnani, then sannyasi is a secondary term used in that case, even if that person is living the life of a नॉन संन्यासी इन कीपिंग विद द आश्रम संन्यासी नैव तस्यापि विवेक वैराग्यादि संपन्नत्व बिकॉज विवेक एंड वैराग्य इज देयर एक्सेप्ट टू ड्यूरिंग परफॉर्मिंग हिज आश्रम ड्यूटीज अदर देन दैट ही इज लाइक अ संन्यासी बिकॉज ही हैज विवेक एंड वैराग्य यस्तु विवेक वैराग्यादि विकलः भोगा सत्या एव स्त्रियं गच्छति स वेदांत प्रवचन पटुरपि न ज्ञानी whereas a person who is you know is an expert in vedanta a scholar in vedanta but has no shamadamadhi then that person is not a jnani at all raga deha anivrutya sa ajnani eva even if he is a vedanta patu still he is not a jnani he is a ajnani atra sthi roopa vishayam adikritya krutah vichara now why do you know you talk about sthri itself so he says here it is upalakshana use he for she also so atra stri roopa vishayam adhikritya kritah vichara vicharah sva vishaya vichara upalakshanartha sarva vishaya vichara upalakshanartha so this will apply to the other gender also and to towards things also so it is not only this is a prathama malla nyaya is used thereby every bhoga the intense the most intense bhoga is kama that is explained and when that is denied it has to be applied in each and every case of every desire raga roopa dosha pratishedas and raga has been mentioned here in the earlier case also this dridatara raga na bhavati adrida raga ityadi there not only raga dvesha ityadi everything can be considered there lobha moha all these are to be factored in सो राग रूप दोष प्रतिषेधश्च द्वेषादि सर्व दोष प्रतिषेध उपलक्षणार्थ वेदितव्यः वन हैज टू एक्सटेंड इट टू अदर्स आल्सो एनीवे सो दिस लास्ट पैरा इज देयर अयम अभिप्रायः व्हाट इज द आइडिया सम अप इज इंद्रियेषु स्वस्व व्यापारेषु व्यापृतेषु अपि न मे तत्र अस्ति संपर्कः न अहम् इंद्रिय वर्गः आई एम नॉट द इंद्रियास इंडल्ज इन द विषयास दैट इज ओके इंद्रियाणि इंद्रियार्थेषु वर्तन्त वर्तन्ते इति सो वर्तन्त इति इंद्रिय वर्गश्च न मम एंड अहंकार इज नॉट देयर विथ इंद्रियास व्हाट अबाउट ममकार नो इंद्रिय वर्गश्च न मम द ग्रुप ऑफ इंद्रियास आर नॉट माइन ईदर दे आर नॉट मी आई एम नॉट देम एंड दे आर नॉट माइन ईदर अहम तो साक्षी कैन नॉट ओन अप द साक्ष्य अहम तो साक्षी कूटस्थ असंग इंद्रियाणि विशेषु प्रवर्तताम वान वा ततो निवर्तताम वा आई थिंक देयर इज अ टाइपो हियर नमे तत्र संबंधलेषु अपि इत्येवं ज्ञानिनः निश्चय सत्वादेव स कर्माणि कुर्वन्निव लक्ष्यमाण अपि न परमार्थतः किञ्चिदपि करोति सो कुर्वन्निव लक्ष्यमाणः इवन इफ ही इज सीन टू बी डूइंग समथिंग ही इज नॉट रियली डूइंग बिकॉज व्हाट इज रियली डूइंग व्हाट इज सीन इज ऑल मिथ्या शरीर फ्रॉम द ऑनलुकर्स पर्सपेक्टिव What is doing is sharira, but from the paramarthika drishti, the atma, jnani, swarupa is not doing anything. Kinchidapi na karoti. So very long tippana across classes, but an important one because it clarifies some doubts which may be there. So anyway, let me just see how much is. I would have liked to do some moola. Anyway, let's just start it. So laya chintana kramah. सकलमपि प्रपंचम ईश्वर स्वरूपतया चिंतयेत् सो दिस इज लय चिंतन क्रम एंड व्हाई दिस इज ब्रॉट अप नाउ मोस्ट ऑफ द टीचिंग इज ओवर बट व्हाई इज दिस ब्रॉट अप सो द रिजोल्यूशन ऑफ एवरीथिंग देयर इज अ सीक्वेंस ऑफ रिजोल्यूशन द वे द सृष्टि वाज एक्सप्लेन्ड लय इज अपोजिट टू दैट दिस वाज मेंशन्ड बाय द साधु अर्लियर आल्सो सकलमपि प्रपंचम ईश्वर स्वरूपतया चिंतयेत् वन शुड कंसीडर एवरीथिंग एज ईश्वर ईशावास्यम इदं सर्वम Now he says, इत्थं परमार्थ तत्वे उपदिष्टे अपि शिष्य मुखे अप्रसन्नताम् आलक्ष्य नूनम् अयम् अकृतार्थः So this guru is looking at the शिष्य and इत्थं परमार्थ तत्वे उपदिष्टे अपि even after being taught in the earlier chapter and this chapter in detail but still looking at this face शिष्य मुखे अप्रसन्नताम् आलक्ष्य On the face, there is a question mark, you know, still a question mark. So some doubts are seen on the face of the Shishya by the Guru. And then the Guru's conclusion is what? Nunam ayam akritartha. Certainly he is still akritartha. He is still not got it. You know, there is no Eureka moment yet. Yataha asya mukham aprasannam aste. Because there is no prasannata, you know. The jnana udaya, even in the in laukika jnana, when one understands it, one cannot control the pleasure, you know, the happiness which comes about by getting that jnana. So it will show up on the face, you know, person will be smiling. You try it in Vyakarana, you know, try some Vyakarana sutras. Once you get it, you know, mathematics also, anything, you know, once you get it, I have got it. That is that Eureka moment, you know. You will smile, end up smiling, because the Stula Sharira mimics the Antakkarana. Some people's faces are not expressive, but then most of the faces are expressive of the Antakkarana. What is there within, it shines forth. Unless, of course, one is cheating. So, yataha asya mukham aprasannam aste iti guruhu nirachinot. He concluded, there is a chinna on the mukha, that there is no, you know, question mark. No wonder, you know, oh, so wonderful. So, there is, ataha punarapitam stula drishtya upadishan. Prapancha laya chintana prakaram aha. And therefore, this prapancha laya chintana krama is taught by the guru. So, it is more of upasana, so that in upasana, the earlier jnana may click. Anyway, so we'll pause here. We'll continue in the next part. Sukham nityam saprakasham vyapakan namurga adhishthanam buddhya bodhyam buddhyer rukyatnum param sarvedanta vidyam pratyak paramah tadeva annamattva nitti me nishchitamatihi. Any questions? Namaste.
Namaste.
Namaste. Hello.